And according to the information I have, you have 226 number of elements. That is, you are informed on how you are supposed to write these elements. For example, you can remind us of what we did in our form one. We talked about first two elements. Can someone remind us? I want someone to state the first five elements. Someone to state the first five elements. Yes, Benita?
Good,
I agree with one of them.
Helium.
Very good.
Lithium.
Yeah.
Radium.
Yeah. Good, love from her. Very good. Today, we are going to look at the components of the periodic table class. What am I saying?
Components of the periodic table.
Very good, clap on yourselves. Very good. The unit table is made up of 20 elements at this level. We discuss about 20 elements at this level. And there are different components that are contained in the periodic table. The periodic table has got rows and columns. We have rows and columns. The rows in the periodic table, they represent periods. What have I said, class? Yeah, the rows represent the number of the periods. And the columns, they represent what we call groups. Now, in the periodic table, we have eight groups. In the periodic table, we have eight groups. You are going to see from the chart. And we have four periods. Now, when we are arranging elements, we arrange them according to their physical properties and chemical properties. That is why we were introduced to the periodic table, so that we are able to group elements according to their physical properties and chemical properties. Very good. I want us to have a look at this chart, the periodic table. From our periodic table, you can see that these are the particle columns. These particle columns, they represent groups, whereby we have group one, we have group one elements. You can see them, whereby we have hydrogen, we have lithium, sodium, and potassium. Group two elements, they are beryllium, magnesium, and calcium. Group three elements, we have what we call boron and aluminium. Group four, we have carbon and silicon. Group 5, we have nitrogen and phosphorus. Group 6, we have oxygen and sulfur. Group 7, we have chlorine. And group 8, we have helium, neon, and argon. You realize that there is a criteria which was used to group these elements. For example, when we talk about groups, you can see there is a similar element here. We have one here. That is, one electron is in the outermost energy level. One electron is in the outermost energy level. That is why helium, lithium, sodium, and potassium have been grouped in group one. One, yeah, hydrogen, sodium, and potassium. They have been grouped in the group. Placed in group one. Similar to beryllium, whereby there are two electrons in the outermost energy level. That is why we have placed them in group two. Same thing applies to group three elements, whereby they have what we call three electrons in the outermost energy level. The same thing applies to these other groups. Now, let us come to what we call periods. As you can see, we have how many? We have how many periods? Can someone help us to identify the number of periods we have from our chart? Yes, Masi.
We have 4 periods.
We have 4?
Periods.
Very good. Clap for her. But you, we have 4 periods. And you realize that these periods, the elements which are placed there, there is a certain similarity, or there is a similarity which was considered for the elements to be placed where they have been placed. I mean, in the specific period. For example, if you can look at hydrogen and helium, they are in group. They are in period. I'm sorry. They are in period
one.
They are in period one. They are in period one. You realize that hydrogen and helium, they are what? They are what? There is a similar characteristic which is there. Who can help us to identify the characteristic? Yes?
They all have one energy left.
Clap for me, clap for me.
Names.
For example, group one elements, they are sometimes called group one elements they are called alkaline metals. Group two elements, they are called alkaline earth metals. And we have group 7. Group 7 elements are called halogens. Halogens. In simple terms, they are called what we call salt formers or halogens. In summary, what have we learned today? In summary, what have we learned today? Who can tell us what we have learned today? In summary. Yes? Yes, we have learned about the periodic table. And we've said the periodic table is made up of groups and periods. Some groups have names. Therefore, in our next lesson, we are going to discuss about the ion formation. For your assignment, I want you to write this down. Write this down, please. Why are group one elements alkali in nature? That is your question, and the class representative, the books and group one of his analysis are alkali.
Hydrogens,